you should know that I've got you on my mind, your secret admirer. I've been watching you.
Challenging Tracy Morgan, anybody on Saturday Night Live, Key & Peele, anybody, Ava Spears, you name it. You a sketch comedian? I challenge you in the United States to come up with something better than this. 10 characters, the Running Man Challenge. Peace. Sketch comedian, street energy from
energy into sweet comedy. So all of this stuff is improv. I'm on the side of the Williamsburg Bridge. And as you see, show this guy hit my bike. I'm a citizen. It's kind of hard to stop these people from fighting. This is where you... And you rent them, and then you can... Everybody out here. Now it's been, which brought to the United States to block here. Of course, brought crime down. Made it multicultural. You know, everybody wanted change. I got it. So here it is. Can't complain now. So that's what I do. With the hipsters coming to Brooklyn and situating themselves in different parts of Brooklyn, be able to change and open up, realize that realize. It's what you're gonna go like. I've been to 25 countries, and I've been abroad. I know Brooklyn's the best. He's the best. Orlando, even though we had the recent shootings. Gonfalous, that family, it's maybe a tragic moment, but Orlando, Disneyland, of course, is the best event that you can pretty much go through as a kid and as a grown-up. So, take that shooting away from over there by Orlando, you're talking about a great city too. So, we're on a nice Wednesday. You know, brother? You doing all right? Nice Wednesday. And once in a while, you see a straggler walking by, enjoying Brooklyn. He's probably been walking that bridge for maybe over 35 years. You probably saw the change that we had in this day and age. You couldn't even walk across that bridge because it wasn't built yet. They made the pedestrian walk. Painted it, made it glorious. It used to be a rape strip where you go down there and get raped, robbed, mugged, assaulted. Now it's look at him. Mine is bike and his tight shorts, a lavender color. You got a guy, look at this beautiful backpack. Water, a little juice, an energy bar, and welcome to Williamsburg. A little helmet. Ain't gotta worry about nothing. Ain't nobody gonna bother you here. You in Williamsburg. You know? You in Williamsburg. This guy's riding a bike in shoes and cargo shorts. Of course, you got your stunt devils. You know, a lot of people think they can ride a bike until you see them crash and hit something hard. You realize that you can't ride a bike. You got people that run and walk here. They don't need to walk or run because they eat. They skinny is all outdoors, and if they run anymore, they're going to evaporate. Some of them are walking and running. So skinny that I can see the ribs. And I can see the date on the penny in the front pocket. That's how skinny these people are. That's how tight they wear their clothes. If you're skinny, you might want to wear a little loose to give yourself some body. If they wear these clothes a little any shorter, it's gonna be inside the skin. People gonna start painting on their clothes. I'm telling you, that's gonna be a new thing, boys and girls. People gonna start painting on their clothes. So they're gonna have to get up 2 hours early so they can paint their clothes on so it can dry out before they go outside. Of course, I must have came here during the slow moment. I can't get no stragglers. So of course I got to detain myself. It's about give and take about maybe 75 to 80 degrees, nice breeze, nice, you know, because I'm black and we don't like the sun. Pick a shade, that's probably why. Even though, you know, spot. We don't like this. And in fact, while I'm here, it's who I'm fine. To cope with life. And I'm gonna tell you something that happened to me. This had to be around in the early 90s. No. About 93. I had joined the military. I had met this soldier. And unfortunately, she was from West Virginia. She was of the white type, of course. And she liked black people. And I wanted to try white people. So with that combination, we decided to hook up. It's a great experience, man. It's talking about a brother who come from Brooklyn. Born and raised in the project of East New York, Cypress Hill Projects. One of the most dangerous areas to join the military. And I hook up with a girl from West Virginia. That don't happen too often. So we hook up. I'm in the military. We're in the same platoon. So we were able to go on vacation together. She had a week. I had a week. We took a week. I went to West Virginia and I hung out with her family. Because, you know, I didn't want to go back home. I just got out of being in a bad area. So I goes to West Virginia. She was like, yeah, we could stay at her father's farm and help him out for a week and you'll love the experience. I'm like, you know what? I could do it. Why not? So we go. We go to West Virginia. So I go to this farm. And I get this like, yo, we are out there. I'm talking about we're so far off there. It was a small town. You know, they had I think when I drove past the sign, it was like 300 people in the town. Like 300 people. Shit, it's 300 people who were sitting on the bench in the projects on a summer day. So I'm not used to this. So I get out there. She said we packed our clothes. And she was like, yeah, try to get you some sleep because we got to get up 3 a.m. in the morning and feed the animals and milk the cows and take care of the farm. I'm like, what? She said, yeah. So I'm like, you know what? I ain't pay for this, you know what I'm saying? I ain't pay for the hotel. And I figure, you know, I'm gonna have sex, I'm gonna have fresh food, I'm gonna do what I gotta do. So 3 in comes along, it's dark. You know, I'm giving her the show. I'm like, yo, there's nobody out here. It's early in the morning. Let me get loose something. You know, so I'm playing with her. She's like, you know what? Nah, we ain't going to have no sex for this whole trip. So I'm like, what?
So yeah, we ain't gonna have rip me. So that's why I came out here. So we could do it all. She's like, nah, we're gonna chill out. You know what I'm saying? Gonna think it over. We're gonna just, you know, be friends, and then we're gonna, you know, have sex later on. So I was like, you brought me all about the West Virginia for this bullcrap? So I'm like, oh man, 3 o'clock. I'm saying, come on, we gotta go to the farm. So I'll go to the farm, I milk the cows, get the eggs. So I'm like, man, this is not gonna work out, man. So she take me into town, take me to this bar. Everybody look like hags, so I'm like, man, I'm stuck. For a whole week, I'm stuck. So on the second day, we get up 3 a.m. in the morning, blah, blah, blah. Milk the cows, the eggs, you know. The horse Daisy, you know, she was running around. And I'm like, you know what? I don't think I'll be able to do it. So the third day, I wake up 12 o'clock in the morning. I say, you know what? I'm gonna see what I can do. So I went over to like push her and wake her up, and she wasn't in the bed. So I'm like, where the hell is she? And she was going for like 2 hours, and I said I wasn't going out in that fucking dark. Excuse my friend to find out where she's at. It was too dangerous. You know, I don't mess with them animals out there. And I heard like coyotes or whatever. So I stayed in the bed. So the alarm woke up again at 3 o'clock in the morning. She's in the bed. I'm like, yo, where was you? She's like, I'm just out. So I'm like, oh, whatever. So we go out, we feed the sheep, you know. Daisy, the horse is running around. The horse is running around. The cows are looking at me weird. The chickens just, when they hit, see me, they just, you know, they run away. I got to run and try to catch the chickens for the eggs. And the pigs, you know, I'm not too fond of pigs, but, you know, I got to do what I got to do. I had to pet the pigs. So on the fourth day, so I'm like, you know what, I'm going to try to catch this girl this time, you know. This time I'm going to wake up at 11 o'clock in the morning. So I wakes up at 11 o'clock in the morning, give her the shoulder. I'm like, yo, come on. And she looked at me and she says, no, we're not doing anything. I'm not doing anything. We're going to do it for a whole week. So I'm like, this is some bull crap. So I said, you know what? I'm going to get me a flashlight. I'm going to take me a walk. I'm going to have to walk this off. So get my little flashlight. I go out. And I said, let me walk this off. Because, you know, I'm getting kind of mad, getting heated. So I go out. I go to the barn. So I say, you know what? Maybe if I feed these animals now, I ain't got to get up at 3 a.m. and I could just sleep in. So I started sprinkling a little, you know, bread for the chickens. You know, the chickens, you know, they started getting kind of close to me. And then I went over to feed the pigs. The pig was like, honk, 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 honk. I'm like, ah, these animals starting to like me. So then I said, let me go over here and milk this cow and get some milk. So I went over there and I milked this cow. I started milking the cow. A lot of milk came out. I says, man, cow got a lot of milk. So the cow looks to me, and I'm looking at the cow. And the cow looks at me, and I'm looking at the cow. The cow looks at me, and I'm looking at the cow. The cow looks at me, and I'm looking at this cow. And this cow looks at me, and I'm looking at this cow. And then the cow looks at me one more time. And I look back at that cow. And I went in. Oh, I went in. I couldn't do it no more. I couldn't take it. So I get behind this cow. I said, shoot. I hear about this on TV. This is what they do in West Virginia. And they say, well, in the military, what happens in the military stays in the military. So she was just a casualty of war. And I said, hey. And that says cow. Casualties of war. So I get behind that cow and I wear that cow out. She's looking back at me. She's looking back at me. She's going, she's not saying moo. She's saying more. More. So I'm like, man, this is, and you know, cow stuff is, she was like extra warm. I think that's probably why they like it in West Virginia. So I'm hitting this cow. More. I'm like, for an hour. Finally, could take it no more. I said, you know what? Oh, man. I'm getting the hell out of here because this is some freaky stuff. And I don't know what I'm doing, but it felt good. So I get back in the bed, you know, take a shower, get back in the bed. It's about 2:30. Alarm goes over at 2 o'clock in the morning. She goes, yo, I saw you leave out where you go. Where you go? I said, oh, I just took a walk, man. I went to, you know, just took a walk, you know, I wanted to release some stress. She's like, yeah, whatever. So we went, and at 3 o'clock, I went with her, you know, just, I didn't want to think that I, you know, I was out there. So I went in there, and then, you know, I see Daisy the horse. I said, how come, you know, I'm thinking, I said, why is Daisy the horse? Every time when we come in, Daisy the horse just shoot to the other side of the barn and hides in the corner. And I'm not paying no attention to it. So, feeding the animals, we're done. We go eat breakfast. So, you know, we went out to town, stayed at the bar. She knows, like, everybody. And, I'm in the military. They blah, blah, blah. They dressing me, you know, appreciate my service and everything. So, we coming up to day five. You know, day five is like, you know, we getting ready to, like, you know, go back to the military. So, day five, we go to sleep. So, she wakes up again at about 1:30 in the morning. So this time, I follow her because now I'm not afraid to go out there and I got my flashlight, but I didn't even keep it on because I didn't want to see me. So I followed her into the barn. Oh yes, I followed her to the barn. And when I went into the barn, call her as butt-ass naked, with letting Daisy, which I thought was the male horse, I'm a female horse, was a male horse, and the male horse is doing her in. So I shine the light to make sure I'm seeing what I'm seeing. When I shine the flashlight, that horse was digging her out. All I heard was Daisy. I shot the light. I'm like, what's going on here? Busted. So this is what she's doing out here in the barn? You having sex with horses? You having sex with the horse? You son of a... Is that the reason why you didn't want to give me any? Because you having sex with the horse? So I turn my flashlight on and I run back inside. And I go on the bed and I say, I can't believe this. So here she comes 10 minutes later running into the bed. And said, I'm sorry. But, I didn't want to cheat on Daisy. Cheat on a horse. It's not cheating. You're messing with a horse. It's animals. It's like considered cheating. Get off of me. So she goes in the shower. She comes back out. So, you know, I got to get back because I'm scorned. I'm a man scorned. She comes back. She says, you know what? I'm sorry. I apologize. And I'm going to give you some now. I'm like, I don't want it. I don't want your horse pussy. Sorry, excuse my French. Don't want that horse twat. Sorry, let Daisy get that. I just want to go home. But before we go home, I'm going to the bar and I'm telling everybody that you fucking Daisy. French, you having sex with Daisy. And Daisy is not a female horse. Daisy's a male horse. So you try to use that name to pull a fast one on me. I know when I see. So... She go, what? You gonna tell everybody that I'm having sex with Daisy? I'm gonna tell everybody you had sex with the cow. So I'm like, what? That's right. You don't think I saw you when you went out there? I followed you too. You had sex with a cow. So I'm seeing this goddamn girl here. I said, she said, yeah, that's why I went out and had sex with Daisy. Because you had sex with a cow. So I'm saying, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? So that's right. You go into town, you said I had sex with the horse. I'm going to say you had sex with a cow. I said, I tell you what. I'm going to still go to the bar, and I'm going. But when I go there, I'm going to say, yeah, I had sex with a cow, all right. And she was the best heifer I ever had in my life. And I'll drop the mic. Peace.
Rock on Rock and Rod TV, Booker's Guest Comedy. And I'm out. And that's not a true story for you weirdos out there. Alright? Peace. Roaming the street in Nice, New York. It's bad to see in court. Cause everybody got that finger trigger-nitis. But only if they had arthritis, the world be less populated with tombstones. 12 years old, smoking the bones, swearing they grown, shooting down their own, cause they feel large as soon the gun is blown. But you gotta open your eyes and don't blink. The black man is coming next thing. Boom, 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 drops another brother, his blood is gushing. And 911's not rushing, or there they go, 5-0. Who witnessed the murder? Now nobody knows. Nowadays, you can't even talk. Try to escape from East New York. I co-create, make it great. I'll always devastate. Never smoking, mad joking, no masturbating. I can write tight, write, I get hype and rude. I run my school and I also rock nights. I take my last call, blast off. So damn hyped, you can say I rhyme my ass off. Knock your sister, leave a blister. You can call me sir or mister. You can't fight these rhymes. It is a tongue twister, minor skeezer, but I'm pleasing your girl, teaser. Tried to knock the boot, she had a disease or something like that. Maybe it was gynecrea, gyria, I would see it, but yo, I would still be a little bit smarter and wiser, intelligent, and I'm also rising, and I'm going home. Way up like 87 Curve, all the way down on the Williamsburg. I'm coming from the heart of Brooklyn, from the heart of Brooklyn. You can't name it, you got to frame it. Rock and Rod is the envy of all the rap. I'm out, freestyle.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, and R&R Productions, coming live from Brooklyn, New York, Crown Heights, first artist off his own label. I'm just going to show you what I got in store for you, lyrically. Yo, yo, I'm a rebel with the cause, cause I'm getting draws, cause I'm breaking laws, I'm kicking down doors, pause, for no cause. Don't speak about me and mine, speak about you and yours. I get in the mix because Allah say so. I lay low and just watch the day go by, thinking of a plan to take out Whitey, man, I'm violent. So I need a 9 in my hand. Now wrong, I never grew up right, no light, no sight. I had plenties of gunfight, side of the time. I got one thing in mind, make mad ends and never do no time. I see a black and I'm proud and my face draws a crowd. How can I show you what I'm really all about? Cause I'm full of ambition, I can feel the sensation. All I want is to drop to act like I'm on a mission. But I be like dust, be blown away. I gotta pay rent, so I'ma go the other way. Time to step up, try my chance, try my luck, and hustle, flex a muscle, and maybe I make a buck. So I pour up and blow up, then I floor up and floor up. Now I show up, now niggas give all the dough up. Now the ends of my friends and my friends bought me a new Benz. My skin's intense, the law forgive me for my sins. What? Yeah, a Rock and Rob Productions coming live from Brooklyn, New York, to you from me. We have a few artists on the label.